story of Klembe Mines and its restoration to former glory is one that is told every year. In the latest ray of hope, the Vice President, Jessica Lupo, has inspected the facility and spoken to stakeholders in the district. She says the mines will be restored and that the Klembe Mines Hospital shall also be reconstructed after it was left devastated by the floods.
Vice President Jessica Alupo started her inspection at Moboko 1 hydropower plant in Ibanda Town Council, then went to Kasese Cobalt Company Limited in Central Division before visiting Klembe Mines Limited in Kasese Municipality. While addressing the gathering at Golf Club in Base Camp Upper Central Division, Kasese Municipality, the Vice President said that the Minister of Energy should advertise for an investor for the mining activity.
We expect the Minister of Energy to advertise as soon as possible. Advertise for the investor to come and take over the management and the operationalization of Klembe Mines. So Minister of Energy, in the next 2 weeks, we expect you to advertise. Please let it be transparent. Because when we get the investor, we can move on with the investor, even if we are to have some counterpart work to do in the mine.
Alupo further said the Klembe Mine Hospital will be reconstructed after it was washed away by floods.
Government will reconstruct Klembe Hospital because we know that Klembe Hospital has been serving a number of people, and we know those people are still there and they still need help. So Klembe Hospital will be reconstructed, as well as Klembe Secondary School. Klembe Secondary School will also be reconstructed, and also Klembe Primary School. I saw a small primary school there.
The district chairperson for Kasese says they are still stuck with people who were displaced when River Nyamwamba flooded.
Also, we have people that are still being regarded as people who are in displaced people's camps. Even for the last 6 years in Impoko, where your office of the president did direct that these people be settled, but the settlement process was not opened. And Uganda Railway Corporation has already evicted them. They gave them a deadline to leave that place by 30th of September. And they are now still staying there illegally, 196 villages.
The Member of Parliament for Musongora North in Kasese District notes that once Klembe Mines Limited and Kasese Cobalt Company are revamped, people get job opportunities. The manager for Klembe Mines Limited expressed concern that some minerals have started to lose their ingredients.
The mines, as of for now, we have up to certain level, which is called 43, we have waters flooding. Now, any mines above 43, they are dry. So you can start mining there, except you will be challenged by the grades you get, because you must, as I said, blend to get a good grade for you to feed the mills.
Once we revamp Klembe Mines, we are going to get an investor. So this investor, who will be interested in the mining, will as well help us in the protection of the river banks. You will recall that when Klembe Mines was still functional, the investors there used to clean the river banks, and whenever it could rain, we would not have the floods that we are having as of today.
At the heart of Kasese District lies Klembe, an old mining town located on the foothills of Rwenzori Mountain. It is home to the historic Klembe Mines, a copper and cobalt mining company established in Uganda during the colonial days. It is also home to breathtaking highlands and River Nyamwamba. In this green vista, Klembe Mines distinctively stands out. Its rusty and visibly depleted structures tore into the skyline. Klembe Mines stopped copper mining in the early 1980s. Since then, the company has been involved in power generation, metal fabrications, and the manufacturing of machinery such as maize mills, hullers, window and door steel frames, treatment of fencing posts, electric and telephone transmitting poles is also done here. These two sections are separated by River Nyamwamba. Story by Gilbert Muhanguzi for the news.